So previously we discussed about the split phase starting and the resistor split phase induction motor. Now today we are going to discuss about the capacitor split phase. So before that the topics was split phase, shaded pole, repulsion motor and reluctance starting. So now about the topic of capacitor split phase. So how it's gonna be look like? This was the previously tariff we did. Today is about capacitor split phase. So give a heading. Capacitor split phase. Okay, so now what will happen in capacitor split phase? We will have a capacitor and it will be attached with the auxiliary winding, and along with that in series it will have a centrifugal switch. So now coming with the circuit, it is the main winding. Okay, and again there will be an auxiliary winding here. Now in series we will have a capacitor and a centrifugal switch. So this is the supply voltage, this is the auxiliary winding, it is having a flux, name it phi A, main winding phi M, and the motor will be there. Okay, it is not look like that, it looks very pretty, but I am drawing, my drawing is very bad here. It happens. So now it is the capacitor and it is the centrifugal switch. Again it is the main current coming through it, the auxiliary winding having a current of IA and the main winding having a current of IM. Now the equivalent circuit will be like that. It is the main winding and it is the auxiliary winding. You can say it. So with that part it will having a having a consisting of a capacitor and a centrifugal switch. Okay, so that is the capacitor and that is the centrifugal switch. We are giving supply here, it is the current passing through it, it is IM, it is IA, and it is the main current I. So now see what will be the phasor diagram here. See, capacitor will improve the phase, right? Why? Because capacitor, in case of capacitive circuit, the power factor or the current it leads. So the main winding is having a capacitor and a centrifugal, auxiliary winding is having a capacitor and a centrifugal switch with it. So the circuit, in this circuit, auxiliary winding will lead. Okay, so this is the voltage, the auxiliary winding will lead, so that part is the leading part, auxiliary winding is leading here and the main winding is lagging again. So the resultant will be that part there. Why it is that resultant will be in this side? Because main winding having a heavier turn than the auxiliary winding, so the main winding current is much better, much greater. Okay, so here main winding current is greater than the auxiliary winding. So because of that main winding is lagging and the auxiliary winding is leading. So the resultant will be leading, right? So the voltage will be resultant will be lagging here. I made a mistake here, don't do. So the voltage will be that part and the main winding current, the main current of this motor will be lagging with that angle of beta, that is the angle, right? Now what happens with capacitor split phase motor, it varies. The capacitor, that capacitor we are using, it is, it changes with the circuit. Some call it capacitor start motor, capacitor start, capacitor run motor. So there are different type of capacitor start motors. Okay, so you can use one single capacitor with it, again you can see use two capacitors with it, so that changes the name. And again I have said that the starting of induction motor, single phase induction motor, gives the name. So it is the capacitor start induction motor and it is the circuit of it. Now the capacitor varies from the capacitor, the value of the capacitor, the capacitor value varies from 60 microfarad to 100 microfarad. Okay, for 750 watt motor. This happens with 750 watt motor. 750 watt motor means 1 HP. And again, the AC electrolyte capacitors are more economical, so you can use more than we can prefer AC electrolyte capacitors here. But the motor should not be started too frequently, otherwise the electrolyte capacitor may become overheated or get damaged. Since the motor possesses a high starting torque, these are used for refrigeration and air conditioner. So these motors are used in air conditioner or AC and freezer. So these motors are used in freezers and AC. So this is the capacitor split phase basic motor. And another application is reciprocating pump. So this is the capacitor split phase motor. This is the circuit and this is the phasor diagram. Thank you.